Hello students, myself Amrita Dhar, Assistant Professor of Electrical Engineering Department of Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management, JIS Group. I will teach you Power System 3.
In this video, I will discuss about overvoltage in transmission line. This topic is included in
Module 5,
Power System Transients. The subject Power System 3, subject code is EE-703A.
Voltage surge. What is the definition of a voltage surge? A sudden rise in voltage for a short duration on the power system is known as voltage surge or transient surge. Now, transient or surges are of temporary nature and exist for a very short duration, a few hundred microseconds. But they cause overvoltages on the power system. Now they originated from the switching and from other causes, but by far the most important transient are those caused by lightning striking on a transmission line. Now when lightning strikes a line, the surge rushes along the line just as a flood of water rushes along a narrow valley when the retaining wall of a reservoir at its head suddenly gives way. In most of the cases, such surges may cause the line insulator to flash over and may also damage the nearby transformer generator or other equipment connected to the line if the equipment is not properly protected. Now, this figure shows a waveform of a typical lightning surge. The voltage buildup is taken along the y-axis and the time along the x-axis. It may be seen that lightning induces a steep wave front. The steeper of the wave front, the more rapid is the voltage buildup of voltage at any point in the network. In most of the cases, this buildup is comparatively rapid and being of order 1 to 5 microseconds. Voltage surges are generally specified in terms of rise time T1 and time T2. T1 and T2 to decay half of the peak value. For example, a 1 by 50 microsecond surge is one which reaches its maximum value in 1 microsecond and decays to half of its peak value is 50 microseconds. Next one, causes of overvoltage. Now, the overvoltages of a power system may be broadly classified into two categories. First is internal cost and second is external cost. Now, internal cost is classified into switching surge, insulation failure, arcing ground and resonance. And external cost is due to lightning. Now, internal causes do not produce surges of large magnitude. Experience shows that surges due to internal causes hardly increase the system voltage to twice the normal value. Generally, surges due to internal causes are taken care of by providing proper insulation to the equipment in the power system. However, surges due to lightning are very severe and may increase the system voltage to several times the normal value. If the equipment in the power system is not protected against lightning surges, these surges may cause considerable damage. In fact, in a power system, the protective device provided against overvoltages mainly take care of lightning surges. Now, internal causes of overvoltage on the power system are primarily due to oscillation set up by the sudden changes in the circuit condition. This circuit change may be a normal switching operation such as opening of a circuit breaker, or it may be the fault condition such as grounding of a line conductor. In practice, the normal system insulation is suitably designed to withstand such surges. Now, first we start with switching surges. The overvoltages produced on the system due to switching operation are known as the switching surges. Now there are three cases. First case is case of a open line. Now during switching operation of an unloaded line, traveling waves are set up which produce overvoltages on the line. Now as you can see in this picture, an unloaded line being connected with a voltage source. Now when unloaded line is connected to a voltage source, a voltage wave is set up which travels along the line. On reaching the terminal A point, it is reflected back to supply without change of sign. Now this causes doubling the voltage on the line because twice the normal value. If the ERMS is the supply voltage, then instantaneous voltage which the line will have to withstand will be 2 into root 2 E. This overvoltage is of temporary nature. It is because the line losses attenuate the wave, and in a very short time the line settles down to its normal supply voltage E. Similarly, if an unloaded line is switched off, the line will attain a voltage of 2 root 2 E for a moment, being settling down to the normal value. This is case of loaded line. Now overvoltages will also produce during the switching operation of a loaded line. Suppose a loaded line is suddenly interrupted, this will set up a voltage 2ZNI across the break, that is switch, where I is the instantaneous value of current at the time of opening the line and ZN is the natural impedance. Now suppose ZN, the value of ZN is 1000 ohm, carries a current 100 ohm, and the break occurs at the moment when current is maximum. So the voltage across the breaker is, sorry, here root over sign is missed, 2 into root 2 into 100 into 1000 by 1000 equals to 282.8 kilovolt. Now to express it in kilovolt, we divided it by 1000, where this 1000 represents ZN and this 100 represents current. Now if the VM is the peak value in kV, the maximum voltage to which the line may be subjected is VM plus 282.8 kV. Third case, now current chopping results in the production of high voltage transient across the contacts of air blast circuit breaker, as I discussed in our previous video. Unlike oil circuit breaker, which are independent of for the effectiveness of the magnitude of the current being interrupted, air circuit breaker retain the same extinguishing power irrespective of magnitude of this current. When breaking low current, example transformer magnetizing current with air blast breaker, the powerful deionizing effect of air blast causes the current to fall abruptly to zero well before the natural current reaches to zero. Current zero is reached. Now this phenomena is called current chopping and produces high transient voltage over the breaker contacts. Now overvoltages due to current chopping are prevented by resistance switching. Next is the insulation failure. The most common case of insulation failure in the power system is the grounding of conductor, which may cause overvoltages in the system. Now suppose a line at potential E is reached at point X. The earthing of the line causes two equal voltage minus E to travel along XQ and XP, containing the current minus E by ZN and E by ZN respectively. Both this current passes through X to earth, so the current to earth is 2E by ZN. Next is the arcing ground. Now in early days of transmission, the neutral of three phase lines was not earth to gain two advantages. Firstly, in case of line to ground fault, the line is not put out of action. Secondly, the zero sequence currents are eliminated, resulting in the decrease of interference with communication lines. Insulated neutrals give no problem with short lines and comparatively low voltages. However, when the lines are long and operate at high voltage, serious problem called arcing ground is often occurs. The arcing ground produces severe oscillation of 3 to 4 times of the normal voltage. The phenomena of intermittent arc taking place in the line to ground fault of a three-phase system with consequent production of transient is known as arcing ground. The transient produced due to arcing ground are cumulative and may cause serious damage to equipment in the power system by causing the breakdown of the insulation. Arcing ground can be prevented by earthing the neutral. Next is the resonance. You all familiar with resonance. Under resonance in an electrical circuit occurs when inductive reactance of the circuit becomes equal to capacitive reactance. You all know about resonance. Now under resonance, the impedance of circuit is equal to resistance of the circuit and the power factor is unity. Resonance causes high voltages in electrical system. In the usual transmission lines, the capacitance is very small, so that resonance rarely occurs at the fundamental supply frequency. However, if generator EMF is distorted, the trouble of resonance may occur due to fifth or higher harmonics in cases of underground cables too. Next, we discussed about external cause, that is lightning. What is the definition of lightning? An electrical discharge between cloud and earth, between clouds or between the charge center of the same cloud is known as lightning. Now, lightning is a huge spark and take place when clouds are charged to such a high potential, positive or it can be negative, with respect to earth or neighboring cloud, that the dielectric strength of the neighboring medium, that is air, is destroyed. Now, there are several theories which exist to explain how the clouds acquire charges. The most accepted one is that during the uprush of warm, moist air from earth, the friction between the air and the tiny particles of water causes the building up of charges. When drop of water are formed, the large drop become positively charged and the smaller drop become negatively charged. When the drops of water accumulated, they form clouds, and hence cloud may possess either a positive or a negative charge, depending upon the charge of drop of water they contain. The charge on a cloud may become so great that it may discharge to another cloud or to earth, or we call this discharging as lightning. The thunder which accompanies lightning is due to the fact that lightning suddenly hits up the air, thereby causing it to expand. The surrounding air pushes the expanded air back and forth, causing the wave motion of air, which we recognize as the thunder. Next, we discuss about mechanism of lightning. Now, when a charged cloud passes over the earth, it induces equal and opposite charge to earth. Equal and opposite charge to earth. Now, this figure shows a negatively charged cloud inducing a positive charge on the earth below it. As the charge acquired by the cloud increases, the potential between cloud and earth increases, and therefore gradient in the air increases. When the potential gradient is sufficient, that is 5 kV per centimeter or 10 kV per centimeter, to break down the surrounding air, the lightning stroke starts. Now, in first figure, as soon as the air near the clouds break down, a streamer called leader streamer or pilot streamer starts from the cloud and cloud towards the earth and carries the charge with it. This is the leader. The leader steamer will continue its journey towards Earth as long as cloud from which it originates fits enough charge to it and to maintain the gradient at the tip of the leader steamer above the strength of the air. If this gradient is not maintained, the leader steamer stops, the charge is dissipated without the formation of a complete stroke. In other words, the leader streamer will not reach the Earth at all. Now, in the first figure, you can see that the leader streamer being unable to reach the Earth. It is unable to reach the Earth. As gradient as its end cloud not be maintained above the strength of the air. Now it may be noted that current in the leader streamer is low, that is less than 100 ampere, and its velocity propagation is about 0.05 that of the velocity of light. Moreover, the luminosity of leader is very low. Now we discuss about the second picture. Now in many cases the leader streamer continues its journey to Earth until it makes contact with the Earth or some subject on the Earth. As the leader streamer moves towards the Earth, it is accompanied by points of luminescence which travels in jumps, giving rise to step leaders. The velocity of step leader exceeds 1/6 of the light, and distance traveled in one step is about 50 ampere. It may be noted that step leaders have sufficient luminosity and give rise to first visual phenomena of discharge. In the third picture, the path of the leader streamer is a path of ionization and therefore of complete breakdown of insulation. As the leader streamer reaches near the Earth, a return streamer shoots up from the Earth to cloud following the same path as the main channel of the downward leader. Same path. The action can be compared with the closing of a stitch between the positive and negative terminal. The downward leader having negative charge and return steamer and the positive charge. This phenomena causes a sudden spark which we call turn steamer with positive charge. Now this phenomena causes a sudden spark which called the turn steamer with the positive charge. Now this phenomena causes a sudden spark which we call lightning, and with the resulting neutralization of much of the negative charge of the cloud, any further discharge from the cloud may have to originate from some other portion of it. I would like to say some points. First, a lightning discharge which usually appears to the eye as a single flash is in reality made up of a number of separate strokes that travel down the path. The interval between them varies from 0.0005 to 0.5 second. Each separate stroke starts as a downward leader from the cloud. Second, it has been found that 87% of all lightning strokes result from negatively charged cloud and only 13% originate from positively charged cloud. It has been estimated that throughout the world there occur about 100 lightning strokes per second. Lightning discharge may have currents in the range of 10 kiloampere to 90 kiloampere. Next, we discuss about types of lightning strokes. There are two main ways in which a lightning may strike the power system, that is overhead lines, towers, substation, etc. First is direct stroke, second is indirect stroke. First, direct stroke. In the direct stroke, the lightning discharge, that is current path, is directly from the cloud to subjected the equipment, example overhead line. From the line, the current path may be over the insulator down the pole to ground. The overvoltage set up due to stroke may be large enough to flash over this part directly to ground. The direct strokes can be two types, first stroke A and second stroke B. In stroke A, that is you can see in figure 1, discharge is from the cloud and to subject it to the equipment. that is over that in this case it is on overhead line. The cloud will induce a charge of opposite sign on the tall object, example an overhead line in this case. When the potential between the cloud and line exceeds the breakdown value of the air, the lightning discharge occurs between the cloud and the line. In second picture, in stroke B, the lightning discharge occurs on the overhead line as a result of stroke A between the cloud. There are three clouds, cloud P, cloud Q and cloud R. Now, having positive charge, negative charge and positive charge respectively. Now, the charge on the cloud Q is bounded by the charge R. If P shifts too near to the cloud Q, then lightning discharge will occur between them and the charge on these clouds will disappear quickly. Now, if P is shifted close to Q, then discharge will occur between them and charge on these clouds disappear quickly. The result is that the charge on cloud R suddenly becomes free because in previous it is bounded by the charge of Q. Now, these are neutralized, so this is free and it then discharges rapidly to R, ignoring tall objects. Now, two points are worth noting about direct strokes. Firstly, direct strokes on the power system are very rare. Secondly, stroke A will always occur on tall object and hence protection against provided against it. However, stroke B completely ignored the height of the object and can even strike the ground. Therefore, it not possible to provide protection against stroke B. Indirect stroke. Now, indirect stroke result from the electrostatic induced charge on the conductor due to presence of charge cloud. A positively charged cloud is above the line and induces a negative charge on the line by electrostatic induction. This negative charge, however, will be only on that portion of the line right under the cloud, and the portion of the line away from it will be positively charged. The induced positive charge leaks slowly to earth via insulator. When the cloud discharges to earth or to another cloud, the negative charge on the wire is isolated as it cannot flow quickly to earth over the insulator. The result is that negatively charged rushes along the line in both directions in the form of traveling waves. It may be worthwhile to mention here that majority of surges in a transmission line are caused by indirect lightning stroke. Next, we discuss about harmful effects of lightning. A direct or indirect lightning stroke on a transmission line produces a steep fronted voltage wave on the line. The voltage of this wave may rise from zero to peak value. Perhaps 2000 kV is in about 1 microsecond and decay to half the peak value in about 5 microsecond. Such a steep fronted voltage wave will initiate traveling waves along the line in both directions with the velocity depending upon the L and C parameters of the line. First, the traveling waves produced due to lightning surge will shatter the insulators and then wreck poles. Second, if the traveling waves produced due to lightning hit the windings of a transformer or generator, it may cause considerable damage. The inductance of the winding opposes any sudden passage of electric charge through it. Now, therefore, the electric charges pile up against the transformer or generator. This induces such an excessive pressure between the windings that insulation may break down, resulting in production of arc. While the normal voltage between the turns is never enough to start an arc, once the insulation has broken down, an arc has been started by momentary overvoltages. The line voltage is usually sufficient to maintain the arc long enough to severely damage the machine. If the arc is initiated in any part of the power system by the lightning stroke, This arc will set up very disturbing oscillation in the line. This may damage other equipment connected to the line.
That's all from today's class. If you have any problem, please contact with me. My contact details is given on the first slide. Thank you.